by virtue of the authority entrusted to me by the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda and the law governing the Defense Forces of Uganda, do hereby commission you to be officers of the Uganda People's Defense Forces at the ranks of Lieutenant.
President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, who is also the Commander-in-Chief of the Uganda People's Defense Forces, UPDF, has today passed out 203 officer cadets at Uganda Military Academy, Kabamba. All these have been commissioned to the ranks of second lieutenant and lieutenant, respectively. Museveni, who congratulated the newly commissioned officers, urged them to pursue more training opportunities and called upon them to observe both military and personal discipline to avoid career stagnation. President Museveni explained that in the past regimes, Uganda had a problem of having an army of illiterate people, which was dangerous to the country.
You have now very good opportunity. You have entered a good force, a force with a very good history, and with a lot of potential for progress, even for you as an individual.
The Physical Infrastructure Committee of Parliament, led by Chairperson Dan Atrijukire, today scrutinized the bill to merge the Uganda National Roads Authority, UNRA, with the parent Works and Transport Ministry. The Public Service Minister, Muruli Mukasa, who appeared alongside Allen Kajina, the Executive Director of UNRA, together with the State Minister, Musa Ichweru, revealed to the committee that over 1,577 workers are going to be affected as a result of the merger, citing the need for 46 billion shillings required for compensation.
And then the costs amounted to 46.443 billion, and then the number of staff affected, that is 1,577.
These two documents we have are from both ministers, the line minister of the sector and the one of public service. We have a figure from the line minister, which is talking of a different figure. Now, public service is also bringing a different figure. This is where we go wrong.
The minister's submission was contradicted by UNRA's executive director after she stated that the compensation to pay UNRA employees is determined by the employer, which is UNRA, and not public service.
Chairman and honorable members, the Employment Act states that the severance package is a negotiation between the employer and the workers. The employer, Uganda National Road Authority Board, sat and made a package for its staff,
adding that the estimation to pay compensation is 196 billion shillings. Minister Muruli, however, informed the committee that the merger of UNRA will enable the government to save up to 57 billion shillings in this financial year. The senior presidential advisor on environmental matters, Professor Gilbert Bukenya, has today halted the dumping of soil in a wetland at Busega. Bukenya attempted to interrogate the Somali national who was found at the site over the illegal dumping of soil in the wetland. Dickson Turinawe, the OCCID at Bulenga Police Station, was called to the scene and he interrogated the Somali national and blocked further dumping at the site until authorizing documents were obtained. Bukenya said this is a site where NEMA evicted encroachers recently, but it's concerning to see that other unauthorized people are carrying out dumping activities in the same wetland.
But in the wetland, and you dump soil, this man must be given a punishment to remove all the dumped marum from here and take it elsewhere.